Welcome to Friendly Math 101. Today's lesson is over trigonometry. This will be part one. Part one, we will go over how to solve for sides of right triangles, side lengths, using trig. Part two will be solving for the angles using trig. So let's get started. To start, we want to recall our trig ratios. So remember, we have our three main trig functions, sine, cosine, and tangent. To remember their ratios, we use SOHCAHTOA. This tells us the ratios for the sides for our trig functions. So in all of these, we're looking at angle A. And I'm going to write off to the side what their ratio is using SOHCAHTOA. So for sine, opposite over hypotenuse. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. Tangent is opposite over adjacent. And I knew that from SOHCAHTOA. Again, we're going to be looking at this angle A, so I'm going to highlight it here. Let's label the sides with respect to that angle. So our hypotenuse is always going to be the same. It doesn't matter which angle we're talking about. It's always the side across from the 90 degrees. Then we have opposite. The opposite side is going to be literally opposite of the angle. So if we're looking at angle A, which we are, we're going to have the opposite side be our opposite side. So that's opposite. Adjacent means next to, so the side next to the angle that we're talking about is our adjacent side. Now we can write our ratios. So sine is O over H, opposite over hypotenuse. My opposite side is A. My hypotenuse is C, so that would be my ratio for this triangle. For cosine, it's adjacent over hypotenuse, A over H. So my A, my adjacent, is actually B. My hypotenuse is C. Then we have tangent, O over A, opposite, which is A, over adjacent, which is B. So those are my ratios for this specific triangle. Let's move on to actual examples using numbers instead of letters. So here we're asked to solve for x. So when we're solving these, we want to look at what we're given. So we're given this angle, 52, and let's label our sides with respect to that angle. So this is going to be my hypotenuse. It's across from the right. Then we have our opposite side. It's opposite of the angle. And we have adjacent. So when we're looking at these, the only sides actually labeled are opposite and adjacent. So I really don't care about this hypotenuse. Now we need to think about what trig function uses opposite and adjacent sides. That would be tangent for TOA. So our trig function is going to be tangent. This time our angle is not labeled with a letter. It's labeled with a degree. So tangent of 52 degrees equals opposite over adjacent. My opposite side is x, my adjacent side is 10. So that would be my trig function. Now we want to solve for x. Now this tangent of 52, that's just a number. It's a number, you can figure it out in your calculator. The one thing we have to remember when we're solving these in our calculator is we need to be in degree mode. To get to degree mode, you press the mode button. It's at the top. And you scroll down. Here it says radians and degrees. So if I scroll over, I want to be in degree mode because this angle is in degrees. I press enter. It's highlighted now. And so now I know I'm in degree mode. Then we can just quit. So second mode, we'll quit out of that. And I'm gonna figure out what the tangent of 52 actually is. So we look for the tangent button, which is right here on my calculator. type in 52, and enter. So that is what tangent of 52 is. So when I write this number, I'm just going to round it to 4 decimal places. It doesn't matter because I'm actually going to use this number when I'm solving, not this number. So this equals x over 10. Let me move that down a bit so it looks better. So we have 1.2799 equals x over 10. X is being divided by 10, so we want to undo that by multiplying by 10 on both sides. That will one out those 10s there, and we get x is equal to, I'm going to take this number and divide it by 10, or multiply it by 10, sorry. So I can just say times 10, and it will automatically bring that number down. So I have 12.8. I'll just round to one decimal place. 12.8. So that's how we solve for x. And one last example here. Here I'm asked to solve for x and y. X and y. So let's look at the angle that we're given. 36 here. Let's label our sides. X is going to be hypotenuse. The 7 will be our opposite. The y will be our adjacent. Now, it doesn't matter which one we want to solve for first. Let's just solve for x first, since it asks for x first. Now, when we're looking at x, we cannot write a ratio with x and y and be able to solve, because we have two unknowns. So we want to use our x, because that's what we're solving for. We also want to use an actual number that we have, so we need to use opposite and hypotenuse. For opposite and hypotenuse, I know I can use the trig function sine. So it's going to be sine of the angle equals opposite over hypotenuse. And we can solve. So in our calculator, we would type in sine of 36. It's about 0.588. Okay, from here, what I want to do is get x by itself. So, since x is in the bottom, it's being divided, I have to multiply both sides by x to get rid of it, or move it over to the other side. So that will one out there. And this just got me one step closer to solving for x, but I'm not totally there yet. These, I just stick next to each other, because that's how we multiply a constant and a variable. Now to get x completely alone, I divide by that 0.588 on both sides. And that will give me my answer. So remember, we want to use the actual number. We don't want to round, because that will mess our answer up. So it's going to be 7 divided by this number. To get that number down, I hit second negative sign, and it'll bring that answer down. Press enter. We'll round to the nearest tenth. X is equal to 11.9. Okay, so now I can go ahead and erase this. I know this is equal to 11.9. And we want to solve for y. There are three ways we can actually solve for y. One, this is a right triangle, so we can use the Pythagorean theorem. We can use trig two different ways. We can use this 7 number or this 11.9. Now remember, I rounded this number, so I really don't want to use it in calculation, because it could throw my answer off. So I'm just going to use a 7. It's a little bit easier. Now here we have opposite and adjacent sides, so we're going to be using tangent. So I'm going to go ahead and erase all of this work for x, and we can start our work to solve for y. Okay, so opposite and adjacent, again, is tangent. It's going to be tangent of the angle equals opposite over adjacent. And again, we'll work this out the same way. I'm going to do tangent of 36.7265 equals 7 over y. Multiply by y on both sides. That one's out there. So I get 0.7265y equals 7. Divide by 0.7265 on both sides. And remember, don't actually use this number, use the number stored in your calculator. So it's going to be 7 divided by second negative sign. And I'll round to the nearest tenth. So y is equal to 9.6. So now I found x and I found y. One thing students struggle with a lot is how or what to multiply. So you're always going to have a ratio. You're always going to have a fraction here. You always want to start by multiplying by whatever is on the bottom. So if there's a variable on the bottom, you multiply by the variable. If there is a number on the bottom, like there was in this problem, you multiply by the number. So always multiply by whatever is in the bottom of the ratio. Thank you for watching, and for more math tutorials, please subscribe to our channel, Friendly Math 101.